Hey guys, welcome to my channel, and I think we all know why we're here today. Right, so you would have seen on the thumbnail that we are doing a reveal. I was contemplating on doing an actual true unboxing, but let's be honest, I'm not a very patient person. So I didn't have the patience to actually wait to film the video. In fact, I unboxed it. I did film a little bit of the unboxing and I did it in the evening, so the lighting wasn't perfect and I apologize for that in advance. My hair is everywhere. Anyways, you probably know already that it is a Chanel item, and as you know from previous vlog that it will be a wallet on chain. The question is, which wallet on chain would it be? So let's head on to the clip of me trying to unbox this and then we'll proceed. And here she is. There we go. Look at that beautiful caviar. I don't know if it's showing nicely. It's really cloudy outside. I'm actually filming this at 11:30 in the morning, and it's meant to have, you know, nice sunlight, but it's not. So I've got my ring light on just so you guys can see just how pretty this thing is. I wanted to also share with you a few things about this bag, and you probably can tell that I still have the tag on it. This is from the 21C collection, which I believe means that it came out in November to January of last year. November last year till January of this year, because it's from the Cruise collection. It says that it is a chain wallet with silver metal or hardware. It is in fact ruthenium, which I prefer, which is sort of like an aged brushed silver, not your usual shiny silver. With like for example, your classic flaps usually have either a shiny silver or a shiny gold or a champagne gold. I find those really flashy, so I actually prefer this. Beautiful diamond quilting, caviar leather black, in case the lighting is not giving you that. Okay, now I've obviously already started using it, but I've kept the tag on because I am not 100% sure that I want to keep it, and I'll tell you more about that. But I'll show you first what's inside here. Now, this wallet on chain, as opposed to the classic flaps that also have the love letter pocket, this one actually serves a purpose. I have my authenticity card in there, and this actually goes deep. Like, it will be, where is it, up to here. So you know how the classic flaps can barely fit anything, especially the smaller one, like my medium one couldn't even fit the authenticity card in there. So this one can. You could probably actually put love letters in there. But what do I carry in here? So this isn't full, but it can be filled further. I actually was able to put in my sunglasses in here. But if I have it in like this normal soft pouch. I could actually fit that in there. I'll have to maneuver some of the contents a little bit, but it does fit. And I'll show you. Hopefully I can close it so that I'm not a liar. The satisfying click of that magnet. So now it's full, and you can see on the sides, let's get that out of the way. You can see on the sides, right, that it's full. So what actually fits in there? So I put my authenticity card in the love letter pocket, got my sunnies, I've got hand cream, I have hand sanitizer, a pack of tissue, and a reusable bag. I don't think that, I also have a comb, right? But what I've done, because usually if I'm carrying a bigger bag, I would have my money and my cards in a card holder. But this one has 6 slots for your cards, so you could actually just go ahead and use those, which is what I plan to do. There are my driver's license, a bank card, my Medicare card, and my private health insurance card. So you never know when you're gonna need them, so I always just carry them around with me. So they're either always in a card holder, or in this case, in the slot. So there are still 2 spots that are empty there that I could fill. Now, apart from this main compartment here, there is also a slip pocket where my fingers are. You also have your zipper pocket where I've got my cash and my coins. And usually that's also where I put my keys so that it doesn't like jiggle around. It doesn't jiggle around, and also it doesn't scratch any of the leather components. And there is another slip pocket here at the front where I put my, transport card, which I rarely use anyway. Actually, I could just put that in one of the other pockets because I walk everywhere here in Sydney. I don't generally take public transport anyways, so that's absolutely fine. Now, let me explain to you, I'm just gonna put them back while I'm talking. Let me explain to you why I haven't removed the tag and why I am not convinced that I am going to keep this. And the only reason why, so I bought this at the boutique here at Westfield, Sydney, and it took a while. If you've seen the vlog that was taken actually, or the clips were taken in the middle of October, and I received the call to pick up the bag on the Sunday evening. So I went Monday lunchtime to go and collect it. And yeah, so anyways, the reason that I am not sure yet is because of, well, obviously the price. I could buy 2 other wallets on chain from a different brand for the cost of this one wallet on chain from Chanel. And the practical side of me is telling me, you know what, return this and buy yourself 2 other things. And I know that it's always the quality, that I should be thinking about the quality and not the quantity. However, I also know that Chanel doesn't have impeccable quality anymore. Like for instance, I'll show you, and I've said this to Kenny before. Once it's full and I close it, I don't know if you can actually see it, guys, but it's the flap is wonky. It's not even. I also have this thing about the chain. I don't know, is it just me, or does the chain look off to you guys? Like, I thought it would be, it seems like it should be thicker or wider, or, you know, I don't know. Like, honestly, if I didn't pick this up myself from the boutique, I would think that this might not be an authentic Chanel, right? I don't know. So yeah, anyways, that's what it is full. And again, I haven't decided if I'm gonna keep it, really, because the practical side of me is thinking, well, you can try it out. And I have walked around with this. I have tried it on. I do really like it. But again, I have that nagging feeling that, you know, you could buy two Gucci's or a combination of two different brands for the price of this one wallet on chain. Or I could return this, get my money back, add a little bit, and get a small Chanel boy bag, which would be able to fit more. And again, if I gave this back and I got my money back, I could get a small Chanel boy from the pre-loved market for almost the same price, really. So I don't know. I forgot to say that, and you would have seen in the unboxing anyway, that it came with this dust bag, and I really like the texture of this dust bag. It feels like a rubbery velvet surface. As you can see, it's got Chanel embossed on there, right? So yeah, I really like it. The length is a little bit long for my frame, and for reference, I am 5'4". If I wear it crossbody, it's all right. And I could always get one of those like clippy things that could shorten it, or I could put the chain or this leather bit inside and carry it like that, right? So there's like other ways that you can carry this. The only thing that you can't do is detach the strap, which I am a little bit annoyed with. Because if you wanted to carry this as a clutch, you're gonna have to put the chain in the bag so that it doesn't show, which also means that you're losing the capacity for it to carry what it fits in now. But again, I guess that's why I've kept this $20 clutch that I got from Salvos, or from Salvation Army Op Shop, because then this will give me that capacity, and look at how beautiful that is, to carry as a clutch. Now this one also has a chain, but the chain is attachable. Like, if a $20 bag can actually do that, why can't Chanel? You know, and I know that the boy bags, with the way they are created, that it's got an overlapping leather strap that sort of like buttons together. You can detach the strap of that. So although it will leave you with those two D-rings, that would be awkward that it's there when there's no strap on. Anyway, you know, you get what I mean. So yeah, that's why it still has the tag, because I am not 100% convinced that I'm gonna keep it. And having tried the WOC, I feel like I would get along with the actual boy bag more than I did with the classic flaps. So yeah, there you have it. I hoped you liked this video. Let me know if you have any questions, comments. What are your thoughts about me returning it and getting a different one, or getting a boy bag? Let me know in the comment section below.